Good afternoon, Madam Secretary, and thank you once again for being here. My name is John Martinez, and I'm a second-year MPP student, a Bonnet Fellow at the Ford School Public Policy. And we were wondering, there is a school of thought that the last recession contributed to the rise of populism and emboldened racists in Europe and the United States. Should we be worried that if it will intensify if there is another global economic downturn? And how should we address this worry?
It's a very important question. I do think that the global recession unleashed a lot of emotions, and some of them were justified because it wasn't, you know, it should not have happened. And when it did, I think many millions of people here in the United States and around the world lost a lot of faith in institutions, both in the free market system of our country as well as in our government. And even though President Obama tackled it seriously and led us out of that, saved the auto industry in Michigan, did a lot of other really good things, it took a while. And so people had, you know, a lot of serious problems economically, and the damage lingered. The other big push for populism, for nativism, whatever you want to call it, tribalism, nationalism, was immigration. And that goes back to the Syrian question, because the real igniting event in Europe was the tens of thousands of Syrians pouring out, trying to escape Assad and Russian bombers. So they were flooding into Europe, and Europe was not prepared. It was kind of hard to be prepared, and there were millions of people who were showing up in Italy and then moving on to, you know, Germany or France. And, you know, Angela Merkel, who is a great stateswoman, took a huge political risk and basically said, look, we're going to take the Syrians, and there were others mixed in with them, but it was predominantly from, you know, the Syrian region. We're going to take them, and we're going to try to assimilate them. We're going to try to give them jobs, training, education. And they took about 1 million Syrians. And that caused a huge political backlash. I mean, the fact is, Germany had a better system than most countries would to actually do what she said they were going to do and to absorb those people. And a lot of them, they may not have spoken German, but they were engineers, they were pharmacists, they were educated. So they have slowly been able to assimilate them, but there still is a big backlash. And so these problems, the economic problems, the migration problems, we need people, again, doing that slow, patient diplomacy that looks boring but can actually make a difference, trying to figure out what do we do about this. Because I will predict that with climate change, you will have even more migrants, and particularly from North Africa, which is suffering from desertification. You're going to have more and more people pouring out of parts of Asia. You've got temperatures in Europe now, 110 degrees, and temperatures in parts of Asia, 120, 130 degrees. People are going to leave, and what are we going to do? And I want to say just another quick word about development. I think it would be really smart for us to focus some development aid to build institutions in Central America to stop the migrant flow, to try to provide, you know, honest policing, to try to provide, you know, support for those governments, even if they are not particularly, effective or even honest. We ought to figure out what we can do. A lot of the migrants are coming because they're scared to death with the gangs. Well, no government should tolerate armed gangs, and we should help those governments crack down and eliminate that gang threat so people don't have to rush to our border because they've seen their father killed or their daughter raped and they don't know what else to do. The coffee farmers are leaving because there's some kind of pestilence that is affecting the coffee crop. We have the best agricultural experts in the world. We should be down there trying to figure out how to help those people stay on their, you know, little farms if that's possible. We could be doing a lot instead of making this huge political dilemma, putting children in cages, abdicating our own values, our own laws. You know, we should say, look, we have to have an orderly migration process. Every country has to have secure borders. Why don't we try to help our neighbors so that they don't have to leave their homes and do more to prevent that flow in the first place?